Hello everyone, in this video lecture we'll be calculating the input impedance or a value for inverting amplifier. So let's calculate this. You can see this diagram. This is an inverting amplifier where input is being applied to the inverting pin here. This is negative pin and this is non-inverting pin here. We are using two power supply, VCC and minus VE, and this is the internal circuit here where RI is the input impedance of this amplifier. AVID is the voltage here, and this is the R naught. This value is R naught here, output resistance. RL is the load, RF is the feedback resistance, R1 is the input resistance at the inverting pin here. V input is the input signal which is applied here. We need to calculate RIF here. Now, if you want to calculate RIF, then this RF resistance has to be, we need to use Miller's theorem for this feedback resistor RF, which can be split into two parts. One at the input side and other at the output port. So we can draw this diagram once again. So let's draw it. This is your RI. This is your voltage source, AVID. This is R naught. This is V naught. So output side, I will get one resistance after splitting this RF using Miller's theorem. So when you split this into two parts, the output part will become RF times of A over 1 plus A. So we multiply with the term A over 1 plus A. Similarly, the input side resistance here is R1, and here the input side which will come will be RF divided by 1 plus A. So RF into 1 divided by 1 plus A will be the term here. This is grounded here. This is V input supply. This is I in, current flowing here. This is your source voltage. The voltage is VID. So this is the net circuit which you get after applying Miller's theorem. Now you will use the circuit to calculate the value of RIF. So if you want to calculate exact value of RIF, so RIF is nothing but, from here we can see, RIF is nothing but R1 in series with the parallel combination of this RF over 1 plus A and RI. Why? Because RI, this end is grounded, this is also grounded, so I can connect this together and keep it together. This end of RF over 1 plus A is connected to RI, so obviously these two are in parallel. So I can write R1 in series with the parallel combination of RI and RF over 1 plus A. So I'll write RF over 1 plus A in parallel with RI. So this is the value of RIF, exact value. But here you can see A is very, very large. So this term will become very small. So parallel combination will be equal to the value of R1 only. Why? Because when you calculate this is very large, this is very small. So obviously the value will be dominated by the smaller one. So this equivalent of this will be this value. But this value is very smaller compared to R1. So I can write RIF as nearly equal to R1 by ignoring the value of this term. So if you ignore this term, you'll get the value which is ideal value of RIF. So this is ideal value, and this whole value given here is exact value of RIF. That's all for this video lecture. We'll see the next calculation, ROF for inverting amplifier, in the next video lecture. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.